Assalamualaikum everybody, we meet again. This is tutorial 03 and in this video, I'm going to cover tutorial for chapter 3, heat effect. First, we go to part A, sensible heat. Question number 1. A 3 meter cube rigid tank contains hydrogen at 250 kilopascal and 550 kelvin. The gas is now cooled until its temperature drops to 350 kelvin. Determine A. The final pressure in the tank, B. The amount of heat transfer. In this question, we have a rigid tank in which the volume is 3 meter cube, the pressure is 250 kilopascal, and the temperature is 550 kelvin. And this rigid is being cooled until the temperature drops to 350 kelvin. And because of this is rigid tank, the volume is still the same, which is 3 meter cube. A. We are going to find the final pressure, which is pressure at state 2. We know that the volume is constant for both state 1 and also state 2. So we can relate both states with this equation, in which we can cancel out the V. So we have this relationship. So after we substitute all the values inside here, we will get the answer 159.1 kilopascal. So that's how we find the pressure. B, we need to find the amount of heat transfer. Because of the temperature is dropping, so we might assume that the Q will be released from the system, which is, it will become Q out. By considering the first law of thermodynamics for closed system, and from this equation, we can neglect out what is unnecessary, which is delta PE, delta KE, and also W. So it will become Q is equal to delta U. And this Q is equal to negative Q out. It is usual when the Q is transferred out from the system, the sign is negative. So we expand this equation until we get MU2 minus U1. Then after we look back, this is for gas hydrogen. And usually, in order to get the value for internal energy, which is U, U2 and also U1, we can find through property tables. But this question is for hydrogen, so we cannot find through property tables because property tables is meant for water and also refrigerant. So we can replace this equation with MCV T2 minus T1. If you notice in the question, we are not given with mass. So we have to find first the mass through the ideal gas equation, which is M is equal to P1V over RT1. And CV, we can find from table A to B, and we have to find the CV at T average. So we know that T1 is equal to 550 Kelvin. And T2 is equal to 350 Kelvin. So the T average is 450 Kelvin. So we find the CV at 450 Kelvin. First, we find the M, which is P1V over RT1. We substitute all the values, it will become like this. Then after we solve, we will get 0.3307 kg. So we can substitute inside this equation. So now we have to find the CV. So CV at 450 Kelvin from table A to B, we will get 10.377 kJ per kg Kelvin. This is for hydrogen. Then we substitute inside this equation, and also T2 and T1. We substitute T2 is 350, T1 is 550 Kelvin. So after we solve, we will get 686.2 kilojoule. Next, question number 2. An insulated rigid tank is divided into two equal parts by a partition. Initially, one part contains 4 kg of ideal gas at 800 kilopascal and 50 degrees C, and the other part is evacuated. The partition is now removed and the gas expands into the entire tank. Determine A. The final temperature in the tank, B. The final pressure inside the tank. In this question, we have a rigid tank, which is this tank is insulated. So this tank is divided into equal part, means we have tank 1 and also we have tank 2, in which both of the tank size is equal. For tank 1, it has 4 kg of gas at pressure 800 kPa and temperature 50 degrees C, and the other part is evacuated. Then the partition is removed and the gas inside the tank 1 will be expanded into the entire tank. So we have to find what is the temperature at tank at state 2 and also pressure at tank at state 2. First, we find the T2. We know that this tank is insulated, means that no heat will be transferred in and also transferred out. So here, Q is equal to 0. So from first law of thermodynamics equation, for closed system, delta PE, delta KE and also W can be neglected out. But because of this tank is insulated, no heat will be transferred in or transferred out. So Q is 0 as well. So now we have only delta U, in which the delta U is equal to 0. So if we expand, it will become U2 is equal to U1. So because of we don't know the temperature at state 2, we just know the temperature at state 1. And this U1 is referring to 50 degrees C, and U2 is equal to U1. So means that U2 will also refer to 50 degrees C. So it can be concluded that the temperature at state 2 is equal to 50 degrees C as well. Next, question B. We have to find the final pressure, which is P2, in which we know that T at state 1 is equal to T2, which is T at state 2 is equal to 50 degrees C. Because of the temperature is similar, so we can relate both of these states by using the ideal gas equation. So because of T1 is equal to T2, we can cancel out the T1 and also T2 here. So after we rearrange, we will get P2 is equal to V1 over V2 multiplied with P2. So now we have to find what is V1 and also what is V2. According to the question, we have two equal parts here, in which if we remove, it will become volume for state 2. So from that, we can relate that V1 is equal to half of V2. So after we rearrange, we will get V1 over V2 is equal to half. We can substitute into here. Then we will get 1 over 2, and P2 is 800 kilopascal. So we substitute here. Then we will get 400 kilopascal. Next, we go to part B, question number 1. Determine the enthalpy of combustion for methane CH4 at 25 degrees C and 1 atm using the enthalpy of formation data from table A26. You are required to assume that the water in the products is in liquid form. Compare your result to the value listed in table A27. So in the question, we have methane to be combusted, and basically the combustion will involve oxygen, in which CH4 will be react with oxygen. Before we start with the calculation of enthalpy of combustion for methane, so we need to write down the chemical equation for the combustion. So CH4 will be react with O2 to produce CO2 and also H2O. Because of CH4 is hydrocarbon, so the only product that will produce is CO2 and also H2O. But before we further with calculation, we have to make sure this equation is balanced. So now it is balanced, so we can proceed with the calculation for enthalpy of combustion. So to calculate the enthalpy of combustion, we have to know the enthalpy of formation for each constituent element in this equation. So HC is equal to enthalpy for product minus enthalpy of reactant. So enthalpy for product is equal to summation of stoichiometric coefficient for product multiplied with the enthalpy of formation for product minus enthalpy of reactant, which is summation of stoichiometric coefficient for reactant multiplied with the enthalpy of formation for reactants. The product is CO2 and also H2O, and the reactant is CH4 and also O2. And because of O2 is the pure element, so we can neglect. So from this equation, it will become like this, in which the product will minus the reactant. So now we have to find the heat of formation for each constituent element, which is CO2, H2O and also CH4. So heat of combustion, it will become like this, in which we substitute in the heat of formation for each element, and it should multiply with its stoichiometric coefficient. And this stoichiometric coefficient we can get from the equation. So it is crucial for you to balance the equation first so that you will get the correct stoichiometric coefficient. This is for CO2, in which it is 1 kmol, and this heat of formation we can get from table A26. Same goes to H2O. We should multiply with its stoichiometric coefficient, which is 2 kmol from equation, and this is for CH4. And the heat of formation we get also from table A26. So this is product and this is reactant. So after we solve, we will get negative 890,330 kilojoule. Next, we need to compare with the table A27, in which from table A27 we can see there are two columns, which are the higher heating value and also the lower heating value. Because of it is mentioned in the question that the water produced from this combustion process is in liquid form, so we can compare this result with the higher heating value. When we compare both of these values, it's quite identical. So that's how we solve question number one. For question two, you have to repeat all the solution step from question number one, but this time you have to change the material into ethane, which is C2H6, and also octane, C8H18. So you just follow all the solution step, you get the HF from table A26, and by comparing from table 27, you will get the heat of combustion for ethane is negative 155,9850 kilojoule per kilomol. And for octane, the heat of combustion is negative 547,0680 kilojoule per kilomol. So I hope you can try at home, and if you have any question, you can ask me directly. So I think that's all for this video. Till we meet again in the next video. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.